Okay, sir. You can just start presenting yourself and then
see. Right.
Anyways, name record Jasna session.
Okay. So where I will get the screen, sir? Start video. I have to. Right. Hi, hello. Good morning, everyone. And this is Satyanarayana. Now let's see something very special. Every day we use a language function, beautiful language function. See, we all, when you meet a person, whether you know well or a new person, the first thing we do is greeting. So when you greet, sometimes it may be in formal, sometimes it may be in informal. Whether it is formal, informal, the way you greet, the way you respond places a lot. That means when you greet in such a way, as the other person's attention you may get immediately, and you can get the response also. And if it is mostly informal, if it's a new person, if you want to greet and then introduce yourself, specific words and phrases we have to use. See, now let us see. There are certain ways of greeting with one another, certain situations and contexts are also there. But we may confuse all our greetings, but they are not greetings. Sometimes we use greetings, phrases and words and sentences. Sometimes wishes and sometimes prayers. Let's see the difference with a small example. Right. See, here is an example. When you say good morning to a person, it means you are greeting him. When you say happy birthday, on a friend's birthday or anyone's birthday, if you wish him, and we can say it's way of wishing and wishes, we can say. So actually, the meaning of happy birthday, the full sentence is, I wish you to have a happy birthday, or may you have a happy birthday. So it shows you are wishing him. Sometimes you may use the words like phrases like long live. So that means you may long live, and I pray the Lord for a speedy recovery. These are comes under prayers. So there we can discriminate or classify these phrases into greetings, wishes, and prayers. Today, let us discuss regarding greetings. So, when you meet a person, we can divide or classify the person according to in three ways. The first one is whether you may know the person or the person may be new to you. So, the person may be new to you or you know the person. Persons like non-persons like the family members, colleagues, students, teachers, friends, neighbors, they're all new to you. When you go outside, when you meet some persons, if you want to introduce a person, if you go to an inquiry place, there you have to greet the person. Most probably they're all new to all of us. This is one classification. So here we are going to learn how to greet a new person, introduce ourselves to a new person, or introduce to any person to a new person. And again, how to greet a person who is known to us. And again, if you want to meet, if you meet him after a long time also, how to greet him. Certain phrases are there, we have to follow. Now let us see. The same, whether the person is new or known, again we can classify into the person may be elder to you, higher official to you, a respectable person to you. Some persons are there, they are peer to you, they are equally as your friends and colleagues, and some are whoever, younger ones to you. So according to the levels of the ages and their positions, we have to greet different. So this should also, we should keep this one also, we should keep in our mind how to greet these persons and those persons. So whether they are, the persons are new or known, whether they are colleagues are equal, or they are elders and higher persons or officials. And again, for these are those, we have to use formal form of greetings and informal form of greetings. So where we all use these greetings, whether to the person with in new or known, higher or peer group, informal way or informal way, most probably the situations are like at home, at a party, at office, at a get together, or in a formal meetings. So many contexts are there we will face or encounter every day. So these situations, we have to greet the persons in sometimes in formal way and again sometimes in informal way. So now let us see what are the formal way, what are the informal ways, how to greet new persons, how to greet known persons, all this, right? So most probably when you greet, that means on the day or after a long time, it means you are meeting the person on the day the first time, or new person after a long time. I think you got it. See friends, so when you greet any person, the most probably the word we use always is hello. What is that? Hello or hi. We greet hello and hi. But most probably we can use these as informal way. Sometimes we can use formally also. Hello or hi. Right. Friends, now let us see how to greet and then introduce. Already I told you, hello or hi. After that, we say good morning according to the time, good afternoon, good evening, like this. So when you say good morning, good afternoon, good evening, after the next word, good morning sir, good morning madam, good morning dear, good morning children, good morning Rajesh. If you say like this, according to your wish, your greet, it shows whether the person is known to you or not. Sometimes even the person is known to you or a new one, we can greet good morning sir. Right. So after you greet a person with good morning, good afternoon, good evening and like this, then the person is new. You don't know the person. You want to meet him for a cause or for any reason, you want to meet him. So immediately what you have to do? We first greet them. Hi sir, hello sir, hello madam, hi madam. Then you want to introduce yourself. See how we introduce ourselves. For example, I am Satyanarayana. Hi sir, I am Satyanarayana. Hello madam, I am Satyanarayana. We can introduce like this. Hi sir, my name is Satyanarayana. Hello sir, my name is Satyanarayana. See, in two ways we can introduce ourselves. I am Satyanarayana. My name is Satyanarayana. But sometimes we can see some persons may introduce themselves like this. Myself is Satyanarayana. So it's quite wrong. Please note it down. Keep it in mind. Myself is Satyanarayana is wrong. Uses. How to use this? How to use? I am Satyanarayana. My name is Satyanarayana. And so many ways, let me discuss. Let me introduce myself. Hi, sir. Good morning. Let me introduce myself. Sir, I am Satyanarayana. So in such a way, you can start the conversation by greeting. Your introduction will start by a greeting. Hi, sir. Good morning, sir. I want to introduce myself. I am Satyanarayana. I want to introduce myself. My name is Satyanarayana. Like this, we can introduce with the other persons. Right. So if you feel they are elder and they are a little bit busy, or if you go to an interview or somewhere, if you want to meet a person in a meeting, and most normal, you can hi sir, hello me, myself, or my name is Satyanarayana. And some persons may introduce like this, I am Satyanarayana from Srikakulam, for example. So they introduce like this, I am coming from Srikakulam. So it's also a wrong usage. So you have to tell like this, I am from, not I am coming from. So these two are very important. Remember friends, myself is Satyanarayana, quite wrong. And I am coming from also is not a suggestible phrase or sentence we have to use, we shouldn't use. Right. So let me introduce myself. Allow me to introduce myself. Sometimes you can ask like this also. May I introduce myself? May I introduce myself? In group meetings somewhere, the persons may ask you, please introduce yourself. Then if you want to take your turn, then you can say like this. May I introduce myself? There also, before that, it's very nice thing to greet like this. Hello, sirs and madams, or hello, sir. Hello, madam. Good morning, everyone. Or good morning, sir. Good morning, ma'am. May I introduce myself? I am Satyanarayana. Like this. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Satyanarayana. Let me introduce myself. My name is Satyanarayana. This is the way we can introduce ourselves. Right. This is one in one way. If you want to introduce your colleague or your friend to another person, in that situation, you can introduce your friend like this. I would like you to meet my colleague, or meet my friend, or meet my colleague. Sir, meet my colleague. This is my friend, or this is my colleague, or this is my brother. Like this, you can introduce your dear ones, or your ones, your colleagues, or any person to other persons. Here also, we will greet. Sometimes we will greet the other person, or both your friend and the other person. See, for example, there are two friend persons. One is your friend. You want to introduce your friend to a person. So then the person name is Ravi and your friend name is Raju, for example. Hi Ravi, this is Raju, my friend. This is my colleague Raju. I would like to introduce my friend. I would like you to meet my colleague Raju, like this. And then you can turn to Raju. Raju, this is our sir, or this is my friend, or this is my boss, like this. He can introduce the person to him. You can make introduction between the two persons by introducing one to other. There we have to use these sentences. This is also very important. Now we have discussed how to greet. And then when the person is a new one, you have to introduce them. Right. After greeting and then after introduction, we will go with certain things. Right. Now it's time to ask something more the greeting. For example, how they are doing all this. For that, certain formal way of expressions are there and certain informal way of expressions are there. And some sentences are there we can use formal and informal also. See, the most known sentence is, how are you? How are you? How are you, sir? How are you, madam? How are you, Ravi? Like this. So when you ask, so it's quite, sometimes it is informal and formal according to our expression. Say, please, your friend, hi, Ravi, how are you? We can say it's quite, it's natural, it looks like informal. Hi, sir. And this is Satyanarayana. I want to introduce myself. This is Satyanarayana. How are you, sir? So this is formal. This, how are you? We can use formal and informal. But if you want to use it in formal, we will go with how do you do? How do you do? See, when you say how do you do, and please observe one thing, this how do you do is not a question. Don't ask like this, how do you do, as a question. What is your name? How are you? We use certain gestures, facial expressions when you ask this word, how are you? But how do you do is not a question. It's a sentence. So how do you do? Yes, you can ask like this. How are you? Little bit difference between asking a question, saying a sentence. How are you? How do you do? If you say, how do? The answer and the response from you or from the person may be the same. How do you do? If the person greets you and then again he greets with how do? Then we have to say, how do you do? If you say, how do? The response will be, how do you? Right. Now, if you say, how are you? Then they may say, if it is formal, if you are expecting a formal response, the formal response is like this. Because a person comes to you and he introduces himself to you and he greets, "How are you, sir?" Then our response should be, "I am quite happy. I'm happy to meet you. I love to meet you. And it's pleasure to meet you." Because he is new to you and he is greeting to you. And he may ask you like that, "Sir, happy to meet you." And you can say, "Happy to meet you. I'm happy to meet you. I love to meet you. It's pleasure to meet you. And I'm quite happy to meet you," like this. So when you say all these, if the person asks you, "How are you?" you can respond like this. Or if he asks you, "Happy to meet you, sir," then you can say, "I am happy to meet you. It's a lovely to meet you, sir. It's pleasure to meet you, sir. It's quite happy to meet you, sir." You can say, "Happy to meet you," like this. And how are you, if a person asks you like that, how do you do? You shouldn't say, "How are you?" to "How are you?" If he asks, he says, he greets like this, "How are you?" Don't say immediately, "How are you?" We have to respond and then you can ask, "How are you?" too. But if it is, "How do you do?" respond, "How do you do?" Okay. For "How are you?" in the informal way of response is, "Fine. Thanks. And you?" Most probably the informal response are in phrases, or in one words, or in one or two words. And the formal way of expression or responding is, most probably they should be in full sentence. If you give the full answer, it shows you want to respect him and you have not that much acquaintance with the other person. Right. So for example, let me say, "Thank you" is formal word, "Thanks" is informal word. If you say "thank you," it shows a little bit formal. If you say "thanks," it's quite informal. Right. See, how are you, if a person say, you just say, "Fine, thanks." You can ask him, "How are you?" But in informal way, you can say, "And you?" If you say "and you" means, "Okay, I am fine. And what about you?" So this is the way of asking, "How are you?" and "How do you do?" Now let us see. After meeting the person, we can say, right, "How are you and how do you?" You can say, "Sir, glad to meet you. Nice to meet you. Happy to meet you. Pleasure to meet you." Already we discussed it. "I'm happy to meet you, sir. Lovely to meet you. Pleasure to meet you." And the responses, the formal and informal way is, "Yeah, and me too." You can say the informal way, "Me too." And you can respond in full sentence, "Me too. I'm also happy to meet you. It's quite happy to meet you," like this. See, so if a person comes to you and after greetings, you met him after a long time. For example, you met him after a long time. "Good to see you again." "Good to see you again," or "Nice to see you again." If he says "good to see you again" or "nice to see you again" means, again means, then you can say the same. "Good to see you again. Nice to see you again." See. So let us see. "Hi, sir. How are you?" "Hi, sir. Good morning. How are you? And after a long time no see, good to see you again." You can say, "Fine. How about you?" "Yes, me too. Good to see you again." Like this, you can respond. See. So, when you greet a person and then if you want to introduce yourself, it goes in a formal way because it is a new situation. If it is with a friend, it's quite most probably a friend or colleague like that. It's informal way. There you greet and there is no need of introduction. But there will be a long gap between sometimes you and your friend or your colleague. So we can say, just see. "How come I never see you?" See, "How come I never see you?" After a long time, it's been such a long time I haven't seen you. It's a been such a long time I haven't seen you. So if you say like this, so "How come I never see you?" or it's been such a long time I haven't seen you. Then you continue the conversation. Hi sir, good morning. I haven't seen you in such a long time. We haven't met so far. Because if you're a new person and he think like that, you will have to go with him from that day onwards. So you should be assigned to a project or something. Then you meet, hi sir, good morning, this is, and I think we haven't met so far. So like that, and how are you sir, and how the things are going on. Like that, we will start our conversation. So when you greet a person and introduce, or if you remember the previous things, the conversation starts with always like this, by greeting and then a little bit knowing how about. Knowing how about. See, so some more sentences are there we can use, or some persons may use, then we have to respond. Because how are you, how do you do, everybody knows. But sometimes we shouldn't know, there some other sentences we may face. The person may ask you, how are you doing? Or you can ask, how are you doing? Not only how are you doing? Then the how are you doing, most probably it is informal. How are you doing? Sometimes you can use, according to your expression, you can use how are you doing a formal way. So for that, how are you doing, you can respond, fine, thank you. Fine sir, thank you, or fine, thank you sir, like this. And then you can ask, same, how are you doing? Most probably we better respond, how about you? The person asks you, how are you doing? You respond, how about you? Between, you give the response, answer, fine, thank you, or fine, thanks. See, if you ask, how are you doing? You expect the response, fine, thank you, how about you? You can ask, how are you doing, sir? Then the person may respond like this, fine, thanks, thank you, and how about you? So this is also one way of greeting. And see, sometimes we can ask like this also, how are things? Simple. How are you doing? How are things? If you say how are things, if you ask, not too bad, thank you. So if you get answer not too bad, thank you, so that means he want to share something with you. He is a little bit busy, or he is having with the crazy things. He's in a chaos, or little bit he may, so many things he want. Then he can say not too bad, it's not going well, thank you. But he can respond thank you, thanks for your, because you asked them about their abouts. So for that he responds thanks. And he want to share, not too bad, it's not going well. That means he want to share something. For example, a person asks you, how are things? Hi Ravi, how are things? Then you can respond, it's going well, everything is good. You can say two words, everything is good. Sometimes if you say not too good, thank you, that it means you want to say something. Then you share, you continue and share it. See, for example, in such a way, again, you can ask like this, how is it going? Hi Ravi, good morning, how is it going? So you can ask like this, how is it going? See, how about you, how the things, how are the things, how are you doing, and how is it going, how is it going? So the response will be, it's going well, it's going quite well, it's going good. You can respond in any many ways. So how is it going? Then you can respond, it's going well, how about you, how the things are going with you all, with you, how about you, how are the things? You can ask the same, but after responding you can say how is it going, right? And again, sometimes you may expect a greeting comes to you like this, how have you been? So how have you been? What about so far? From this up to this time, how about you all? You want to know all these in a simple one, in a simple, great, simple greeting. How have you been? How have you been? And the response should be, I'm good, I'm too good, and I'm great. And you can say, I'm great, or simply great. If you add sir and madam, right, it becomes a little bit formal. Right, see? Yeah, or if a person asks you, how have you been? Then you respond, I'm good. Hi, Ravi. Good morning. How are you? You can expect like this. Hi, Ravi. Good morning. How are you going? How are the things? Hi, Ravi. Good morning. How are the things? Hi, Ravi. Good morning. How do you do? And hi, Ravi. Good morning. How have you been? Hey, Ravi. Have been such a long time. Where are you, man? How are you? Just these type of conversations we can see and we can face. We have to use in our day-to-day life before when you want to greet any person. See, and nowadays when one type of greeting you can see in the especially in offices in the morning walks like this, in when you meet a person in the shopping mall, like some persons. Hey, hello, Razu. How are you, man? What's up? So we can get to what's up. So according to thing, I am doing this thing. Then it's what at present what you are doing, or what the things are going with you all at your heart is or something. You can tell all this. If the question is what's up, if the greeting, if they want to know about what's the things are going with you. He may ask you like, what's up? So, see again. Hi, Razu. How are you? It's been such a long time. What's up? So, there is a different meaning. Hi, Ravi. Good morning. Hi, Ravi. Good morning. How are you? What's up? So, this is also a way of responding and asking something. See. Now, if you see the way of greetings, then you should know the way of responses. So if a person greets you, we should know how to respond. And if you want to greet a person, you should know how the person reacts and responds according to the conversation will continue, according to our way of approach and expression. See, sir, friends, let us see, there is a conversation between friends, a businessman, after a long time we have discussed. Right? If you go to a shop, there you can see a shopkeeper. He will ask you, good morning, sir. What can I do for you? How can I help you? What can I do for you? So finally, you can say, after the business is over, he may say, nice to meet you, sir. Or you can say, glad to meet you. And you can take farewell or say goodbye. Right, in the coming sessions, we can see different ways of which is how to wish, that's how to show our prayers, how to show our gratitude, and everything, and how to take goodbye also in coming videos. Thank you, friends. Have a nice time. And this is Satyanarayana from Srikakulam. I would like to show my gratitude to my beloved friend Jagan, who make this big, who has given this big platform. And then, friends, here is a small request. You know all well, there is a big crisis regarding Corona. So, friends, please stay at home. Take care of, take every minute caring step, and take care of you and your family. And let's pray the Lord. Soon we will have a corona-free world. Thank you.